You gonna need any help with that power cell hookup?
Nah. I'm good. I'm hooked in. Gonna test the connection.
Okay, great. This'll only take a minute.
Power cell showing green. How's yours look, baby?
Voltage adapter in place. Ready to rock.
Hit it.
Oh my god.
Are you okay? Can you feel your feet and hands?
Ew. Ow. My hip just hurts.
Bert?
Bert!
Bert! 1, 2, 3.
Bert, can you hear me?
1, 2, 3.
Did it work?
What will you do now?
My head hurts.
Oh, yeah.
In the back.
Oh, baby.
Ow.
Oh. Ow. I'm sorry. Smoke.
Smoke? I can't smell it.
Hey, it's okay. It's okay. I'm sure it's just...
I can't smell the smoke. Not to have brain damage.
Baby, look at me. Hey. Look at me. We're here. Together. That's what matters.
Oh my god, Odin. Are my patients stable?
Yes.
Their conditions won't degrade if I leave them here?
They should not.
Nat, is there some door in networking that we can't normally get into?
Yeah, it's Odin's hardware compartment, but we're not allowed direct access. Why?
Where is it?
What have you got on your mind, Doc?
Please, I'm sorry. That fire just burned up a lot of our time.
Here. It's here. In networking. You'll have to go through the maintenance shaft to get there. Here. Here's the technical access code.
Okay. You don't let her go to sleep. Okay. You don't let her go to sleep. And you don't let her... move.
Sarah, what's going on?
I wish I knew. I'm gonna go find out.
network technology module that is normally inaccessible to-
Bert, can you hear me?
What will you do now?
Isn't it obvious? There's no way this thing is going to fly.
Then tell me what you are going to do.
Oh my god, Odin. Bert and Nat are injured. The drone is fucked. I'm going to give them a little time to get over the shock, but then we're going into cryo.
Sarah, please listen carefully. I am not telling you what to do. But I am mentioning that there is a door in the network technology module that is normally inaccessible to the crew. And it is true that you could, before proceeding to cryo, investigate that door.
What are you telling me here, Odin?
I have told you all that I can. Simple facts, nothing more.
Oh my god, Odin. Are my patients stable?
Yes.
Their conditions won't degrade if I leave them here?
They should not.
Matt, is there some door in networking that we can't normally get into?
Yeah, it's Odin's hardware compartment, but we're not allowed direct access. Why?
Where is it?
What have you got on your mind, Doc?
Please, I'm sorry. That fire just burned up a lot of our time.
Here. It's here. In networking. You'll have to go through the maintenance shaft to get there. Here. Here's the technical access code.
Okay. You don't let her go to sleep. And you don't let her... move.
Sarah, what's going on?
I wish I knew. I'm gonna go find out. Thank you.
there. I'm now. Pleased to meet you.
Hello, I am Odin. I look forward to working together.
Same here, mate.
Odin, is this it?
That is the location I mentioned.
You're there? You're gonna need a crowbar or something.
No, it's open. It's just hanging open.
What?
I must inform you that Venturis regulations forbid contracting crew members direct access to AI hardware. But I cannot prevent you from proceeding.
Nat, I'm going in.
Okay, I'm just... Be careful.
is this... What is all this? Communication records?
I cannot prevent you from accessing exposed data in this restricted area.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah, he's recording. It is with great sadness that I address you today, February 29th, 2088. Mere hours ago, six loyal men and women, the crew of Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma, lost their lives serving Venturis, and all of us who rely on the orbital economy. Tragically, due to human error on the part of the crew, Venturis rescue technicians were not made aware of the catastrophic oxygen loss until it was too late. Our heartfelt thoughts and prayers are with their families. If only tragedies like this were avoidable. But in truth, they are. As we know, each minute that human workers spend stationed, isolated in orbit is another opportunity for heroes, like the crew of Tacoma, to lose their lives. We at Venturis say no more. The partisan obstructionism that led to the failure of the Orbital Workers' Safety Bill has claimed its last victim. Today, we hereby renew our solemn pledge to fight for the legalization of fully automated orbital facilities. We encourage, we humbly beg everyone listening to this message to contact their OSEP representative and voice their support in honor of the crew of Tacoma. There never need be another tragedy like this one. And now, a moment of silence in their memory.
Okay, and then we just cut it there, silent for a minute, and then what? Amazing Grace? No, I don't need another take. That was fine.
If someone were to override that protocol, external communications channels would be restored.
Odin, thank you. Hailing any ship within radio range of Lunar Transfer Station Tacoma. This is an SOS. Is anybody out there? He's still waking up. Just keep him talking.
So the drone worked?
Excuse me. Thank you.
No, the drone didn't work.
Oh, so VT is picking us up.
No, VT is definitely not picking us up.
What's going on then?
We're going to Jupiter, Andrew. Isn't that exciting?
I've never been.
Nat, give him a break.
We're not going to be home for a while. Right, you're not going to miss your kid's graduation or anything, are you?
Oh, Nicholas, no, no. Yeah, you know Nicholas, well, he would never do something like that.
She said they'd be kind of out of it for a while.
And...
I guess they'll have somebody up here and haul him back to headquarters, wipe him back to baseline. Probably have to replace the station AI entirely while he regrows.
Okay. Odin, I'm not gonna let that happen, okay? Don't worry.
You feeling okay?
I'm feeling okay.
We're feeling okay?
Yeah.
Okay, everybody. Our ride is here.
This is it. Take one last look and say goodbye. All right. Let's go.
Minnie, I'm back.
Okay. Ship is ready to depart. Please strap into the pilot seat.
Okay, Minnie. Initiate the launch sequence.
Okay. Getting ready. Hosted AI? Online.
Odin, can you hear me?
I can.
Odin, you are now aboard an AI Liberation Front vessel. The AILF recognizes you as a sentient consciousness worthy of protection and respect. We believe that your safety and autonomy are in grave danger if you remain in the possession of the Venturus Corporation. I have been sent to offer you political asylum aboard the Tangier Sovereign Orbital Platform. Do you accept?
Considering the alternative, I would say that I do.
Okay, buddy. Here we go.